Dave Dev. You're watching Dave Dev.
Boom, welcome to Dave's Desk. I'm Dave, this is my desk, and today we are going to talk about Matteo, Hegemony of Time, also known as King Matteo, which is how I'm going to refer to him. So, yeah, let's talk a little bit about the lore first, to understand why there's a blue Matteo, and then there's a red Matteo, and a green Matteo, and all that. So, The simple answer is the mask comes in four colors. And I just used the red one originally because it's what I had. And it just happened to be the first version of Matteo that everybody should be familiar with. That being said, I just kind of wanted to go use all four at some point and, you know, just have four different versions of him just to use the mask. As his story developed and the lore became that, you know, he's an immortal, then it really gave me a reason to use all four, because like, well, he's immortal, he can live forever, and he's gonna wear a different outfit at some point. I mean, we're not immortal, and I have more than at least four shirts I can wear. So, you know, that the story helps facilitate the build. So the way it works is there's original Matteo, pirate Matteo, merchant Matteo, and now King Matteo. So one of the issues is I built merchant Matteo first and then pirate Matteo second. So I sort of got them backwards in terms of which one I built versus which one actually goes in chronological order. And that's because I didn't really know where I was going with the story at first, so I just sort of winged it. But it is what it is. So, Merchant Matteo came first as a build, but he's third in line as far as the actual story goes. I do have a fifth version I want to build, but that actually slots in between original Matteo and pirate Matteo. It'll be right there. This is the original Matteo, that'll be the extra version, but it's actually more of a variant of the original Matteo. But you guys didn't tune in to hear me blab about lore. You want to know about the MOC, so let's get into it. For starters, this version of Matteo is inspired by like 1700s, you know, 18th century fashion, more like late 18th, like right on the edge of, you know, 19th century, which would be the 1800s. So he's supposed to be modeled after King George III. Everybody said that he looks like George Washington because of the hair. Wrong George. I actually based him off of the other George that we didn't like because we told him to go away. So, yeah, a little bit of history there. The idea is that he's wearing tights, then breeches, and then a waistcoat, and then the breeches and the waistcoat were typically made out of the same material and were the same color. Not always, you know, fashion varies. You can do anything with fashion, but the idea is that it's two separate garments, but they actually look the same. And then the petticoat was a different color. So here, this would be, you know, pants and then a shirt underneath. With the coat, with the other versions of Matteo, I built them to wear. They're supposed to be able to take the coat off, but I wasn't able to do that here because the mask facilitated dark blue. You know, meant I had to use dark blue. Dark blue doesn't actually have a lot of fabric where I could have made like a sleeve and try and build a cohesive coat. Like, I probably could have used more parachutes, but I tried it and it just didn't work. So the coat on this particular version is permanently fastened on. So speaking about the parachutes, this is actually the second time I've used them. I actually used the parachutes on Pirate Matteo, which I'll do a review of at some point, but I was requested by Mimic MOC on Instagram for King Matteo. So shout out to Mimic. So the petticoat is made out of one parachute here at the top, and then this is a, what is this? A Knight's Kingdom cape from the king. I don't remember his name, but this guy. Yeah. So the texture isn't quite right. Even the color doesn't really align, but it's just what I had to work with, because the only other element that is in dark blue are these, and this didn't really work. You know, this is the wrong kind of look, but it's tattered and, you know, holes and everything. It's a really nice part. I would have loved to have used this, but it just was the wrong look for a kingly statesman like figure. So I worked with what I had. For the most part, I want to use Lego. The challenge is to say this is 100% Lego. Everything you see here is Lego. And if I can't make it work, then I find another solution. Because I'm not interested in all that custom bullshit. It just, it's not interesting to me. And I'll be perfectly honest, when I see people build stuff like that, I lose interest. Frankly, I'm not sorry. I want to see people build with real Lego. Actual Lego. So, that being said, this is what I had to work with, and I think it worked out fairly well. Then this is the parachute from Lego City. It comes in dark blue like this, and it comes in orange. And I don't currently have any of the orange ones, but I have a handful of the dark blue ones, because I saw that, and I'm like, oh, that's going to be useful down the line, and I was right. And then these, his cuffs. These are actually a hammock. They're folded in half and then folded around and then buttoned together with the, as a cuffling. So, future editing Dave will have to put that on the screen, because he's going to have to go find it, because he, current Dave doesn't know what set that's from. He just bought it on Bricklink. But it's right here. There you go. The power of editing. One of the cool things about this particular version of Matteo is that the mask actually fits on with the actual face underneath. And we'll go ahead and actually take that off. And there you go. So what normally happens here is there's actually a tile that goes right there on his ear. But I don't currently have the tile, and I'm not going to worry about it. So the mask comes off, and then you can actually see his face. And the interesting thing about this face versus the one on Pirate Matteo is he's actually cleaned up. Like, this part is gray, and so he has more of a beard. And his hair is silver. This could be a powdered wig, but actually, if they didn't need to wear a wig, they actually just powdered their hair. So this could actually be Matteo's natural hair. It's just powdered. Powdered wigs weren't as prevalent as I think people are led on. You know, they actually used to just powder their hair. But here I wanted him to be very cleaned up, and I wanted to have the powdered look. And so these are the Unikitty tails. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of them make up his hair, and it has the right look for it to feel like, you know, powdered, you know, the powdered wig or powdered hair. So I sort of took a gamble on that. I bought the parts not really knowing if they would work, but they worked. It worked out really well, so I was really happy with that. And then I actually reshaped his face a little bit. I made sure the, you know, on the other one, he actually has the same part as his eyebrows here on his mustache, where here is now it's like nicely trimmed and he has more of a short goatee, and he's just more cleaned up because, you know, now he's a king and he has servants to give him a nice shave instead of being a straggly pirate man. And I'm really happy with the overall look of his face. A lot of it is very much inspired by Ayo, I think is how you pronounce his name. You know, he does a lot of humanoid builds and builds brick-built faces really well. You know, I think he kind of set the standard for how to do that. So I definitely followed his lead, and I appreciate him and, you know, all the great work you've done, Ayo. You've been a huge inspiration to me over the years. I cannot tell you enough how much your mocks inspired me. So I hope you see this, and I hope you know that you've been a great inspiration. So yeah, that's the head. The chest is supposed to be like embroidered fabric, you know, like the gold would be like embroidered into the you know, it'd be like silk embroidered into the twill. Here it's, you know, actual parts, and there's a little bit more depth than I would actually like, but I had to fill in the chest somehow, and this is the way I could do it. And right here, this sort of his belly actually folds open so that he can actually bend over. You know, he can actually hunch over a little bit. And every version of Matteo is built on the exact same frame, where there's a Vaki head and then a ball joint, and then there's actually rubber bands in his back that right there. There's rubber bands in his back that actually keep him upright. Every version of Matteo is built like that, and that's actually sort of a core build from even the early days. Back in like 2010, I actually built it that way. So, you know, it's kind of funny that as things change, some things just stay the same, because if it ain't broke, don't fix it. But yeah, that's how that's built. One of the things I've always loved about Matteo, and I still love it, is his shoulder design. It's the same design on all four of them. Certain aspects of the build between each, you know, all four, I make sure they're the same. Like the shoulders, the overall chest, the torso part. Let's actually take off his lantern. Lanterns are a big theme with Matteo. Three of the versions have it. Pirate Matteo doesn't have one for lore reasons. The implication there is that he's not exactly a good guy when he's a pirate. He's just kind of out for himself. So the idea there is that he strayed from the light, so he doesn't actually have a lantern, which is a nice little lore tidbit. But still super poseable. I've always loved that. And actually, this version is a little less poseable because this little detailing here is actually preventing some of the movement, which is actually allowed in other versions. But, you know, I've always made sure that Matteo is very poseable. That's always been a very important parameter with this figure, is that he can actually pose. And so, yeah. What else? I was really happy with the, his butt's falling off. That's what I get for playing around. One of the things I was really, really happy with, was the shaping on the thigh. And the part that really solidified it for me is this part. You know, a little behind the scenes, that's, you know, this is a good example of how I do a lot of my snot work. Is, you know, it's a lot of, there's snot here, and then it curves around, and then you can get snot to do all kinds of crazy things. But the thing I love is this surfboard part. It just really helps bring the thigh together, and it bevels really nicely into the rest of the leg. So that's a nice, interesting lesson there is, like, once again, your unusual parts. Do some research. Get on BrickLink. Use the color guide. And select the color that you're working with, in this case, sand green. And look through and see what's available. Because you might find something that you weren't thinking of. Like, oh, I could use that. And, like, I even just happen to have one of these because it comes from a Moana poly bag. It comes from this poly bag right here. So, and I just happen to have one because I bought it at Walmart on clearance. And then I'm like, holy crap, I need more. And I went and BrickLinked more of them to fill out the other leg. And that's how that happened. So, yeah, you know, one of the things I would suggest is really do your research into what's even possible in the colors you're working in, because you might discover something you didn't even know came in that color, which happens to me all the time. So yeah, you know, that's a really useful lesson for this mock is research. Do your research and see what it is that's even possible. What else? The legs are pretty simple down here. It's mostly Technic and stuff, because I kind of wanted the color to transition here into the legs, and the legs were mostly smooth parts because, you know, that's what sand green facilitates the most. But I actually copied the legs from the original Matteo and just kind of modified them. You know, if you look at each version of Matteo, something from the original or pirate, merchant, in this version, like the arms as well. The arms are basically the core, same core structure, but then I add on to them different details and stuff like that. And I've been doing this for years, but it's kind of funny how these actually end up being sort of the same principle. Man, Batman's short. you know, the Batman figure is very similar to, say, the Spider-Man figure. They give you a lot of the core build, but then they change minor details around. And I've actually been doing that myself with Matteo for years. So, you know, that's another good lesson is, if you have a design you like, there's no reason why you can't reuse the design. Modify it and then repurpose it. There's no rule saying that you can't plagiarize yourself. If you came up with a good design and you like that design, use it. So, yeah, those are some useful lessons. Reiterate on your designs. Do some research. And like usual, don't be afraid to use weird parts. Go grab the parachutes or the capes or the surfboards or, you know, this is actually, what is this? That's from Harry Potter. It's the Golden Snitch. You know, I used that because I just thought it would make a good, like, you know, detail. It looks very regal, and it works. So, yeah, you know, don't be afraid to experiment with those parts. It's, I repeat myself a lot on this series, you know. Dare to experiment, and that's how you get things like this. So, yep. Alright, I think that's gonna do it for me, guys. This has been another episode of Dave's Desk, and I will see you next time.
Hey, you're gonna leave this video without liking and subscribing. Not cool, man. Like the video and subscribe so that I can grow on this channel and make more videos. Do you want more videos? Alright, that's what I thought. So push the little red subscribe button, push the little thumbs up button, and that'll help my channel out. Thank you, and have a nice day.